out right now. But it's time for game number two. Veggy with Birdie against Jester Paul with Vega. This is a 1-7, of course, so these guys have a lot of games to adapt to each other. They're starting with the trademark, but of course Veggy has been playing Colleen lately. And Jester Power plays a bit of Poison as well, so we might see a character change depending on how the set goes. Alright. The opening immediately goes for Veggy, putting Jester Power in the corner. Of course, the classic, the sweep! The footsies! And Veggy with the patience. No, there's only so much he can do right now. It is a player dry enough to rival Jester. That's why I wanted these two to face each other at the terminal. That's why I thought this would be an interesting fight, because both of these guys are dry as hell. The driest. The driest! Jester Power backs himself to the corner. Oh, and gets away with the flying Barcelona. The spinning. And wakes up with the armor. Oh, uses the this V-skill too. I didn't realize that he was using this V-skill for this matchup. But to be honest, with Vega having flying Barcelona, is definitely the V-skill of choice, I believe, in this matchup. Rather than just throwing cans that he can jump over. Alright. Very dry, of course, between these guys. You know that these guys are not players who like to take risks. And Veggy meets him. Just up with a jump away. Looking for a way, but Veggy's control is so good. He stays at a range. Oh my god. That was faked. He stays at a range where the forward dash would be punished. The damage. Veggy gets game number one. Birdie putting in work. Definitely clean. First game in a set that's definitely going to be a full clean set. What's up, FMAB? These guys could change, of course, character shots to Team Fox Games for the follow. But this is going to be a fun set to watch between two very methodical players. No character change yet. Veggy 1, just a power 0. Alright, another Claw player, FMAB. This is Europe. We've got a lot of Claws. And Nassim Claw hasn't been there yet. Alright, nice! The conversion as well. Yo! Just a power. Into the jump in. Gonna get the small conversion of this one. Veggy in the corner, but don't need much to finish this one anyway. The next opening should finish building that critical art for him, so no risk taken. No risk taken on Jester's side. He's got the slight life lead. No more Claw as well for him, so a bit harder to zone him away. Veggy using the jump ins, and of course, the counter hit conversion was perfect. Once again, the round goes on Norway's side. Nice. Trying to give Vega a taste of his own medicine, but Jester doing well. Oh, the backdash gets away. Okay, gets away. But again, the huge life leads on Veggie's side. And that's gonna be another game for Veggie, that birdie. Listen, yeah, we're two games in and it's probably longer than the previous game, I agree. I do agree with this. 2-0 for Veggie. Will just a power bust out the poison? Will he bust out the poison? Or will he keep going with Claw so far? It looks like he's having a lot of trouble just matching Veggie's pace, so... Alright, finally just a power. Oh my god! Take the risk! Not a massive risk anywhere. He got this one, but Veggie escapes the corner. Into the command grab, of course. He's gonna put him in a situation where he can doubt, but the wake up backdash, of course. Jester's not having any of this. And he's getting his round, looking to bring it a bit back on this set. Oh, the backdash. Okay. Slippery movement, but Veggie always trying to keep his distance. I mean, Veggie is a very... It's a player that I really like watching for a reason, because he took a while to get like good at SF5. He was extremely good at SF4, and I think when SF5 came out, like he took so long to adapt to the SF5 meta, to the way you play at SF5. Kind of gave up for a while, because like he had real life stuff coming. But then, with Gfinity Elite Series and Nordavind, he was like, nah, I'm taking the game seriously again, and little do you know, the man ends up in top 8. It's definitely a player doing work. Oh my god, what a reversal. Clean usage. Oh, the chain? I was gonna kill it, of course. Veggie waiting. Both of them waiting. It's a one touchy on both sides. Oh! Takes the risk but escapes. No punish though. That could have been neutral jump and the overheads. He's going to take it. Veggie is looking comfortable. Veggie is looking comfortable in this set. Yeah, ball strike. I agree with Verdoyance, right? Like, why would you pick this skill 2 against Birdie? Wouldn't this skill 1 do the job? Oh, nice! Into the bubblegum, but keeps his distances. Safe social distancing applied by just the power there. You'd go for 2 as well, Bolt, okay. The dryness is back. Jester is looking for a way in, but... But more Jester is just trying to get that life lead and escape, but... Veggie doesn't press any button, happy to wait. Into the activation, but walk forwards. Oh, nice. Into the max damage. Is that gonna be enough to kill? That should be enough, right? Just a power maximizing the damage output of this one situation. And that's gonna be 2-1. Just a power getting his first game in this set. First to 7 is alive. The first to 7 is alive. Jester showing why he's keeping Claw. On this set, much love to Heavenly Morse, Olson, and C. Sean? Sean CC for the follow. Welcome, guys, to Wanted Episode 5. Veggie against Jester. Ooh. The sweep is there. Gets the throw. Jester in control this time. A great start for him. Okay, into the command grab. And Veggie now in the lead. Veggie in the lead. Look at the patience on both sides. 27 seconds remaining, and that's gonna be the one conversion by Veggie. To get it. He's looking very comfortable in this matchup. Alright, the crouching into the conversion. Ooh, the neutral jump conversion, and Veggie with the dominant round, looking to get the meaty overhead. That was the fastest round in this set so far for Veggie to make it 3-1. Birdie is definitely doing the job. The more we go, the more I'm wondering if Jester Power will keep Klo. Or would he try? Would he try something else? After three games, that might be the best time to try another character, so you still have the safety of going back to Vega. But no, decides to go for Vega. No change in Jester Power's approach. Yeah, he does play poison. He was telling me that he was planning to test Vega and see like how it goes on the matchup, and if it doesn't go well, he would go for poison. So I'm curious to see if he will whip out the poison or not. Okay. The activation on hits. Yeah, uses the chain. Good challenge. Jester in the corner. The jumping is anti-air. Ooh. Ooh, good movement. Killing as much as he can from this situation. And Veggie with the back roll. Trying to bait Jester Power into pressing a button at this range. His button would have lost. But good patience on the Jester side. Look at the patience. Look at the stare down between these guys. The crowd is watching and they're like, nope. And the overhead is gonna get the birdie down. Jester Power being more and more comfortable in these sets. Alright, patience again. I'm waiting, the patience again. On both Jester's and Veggie's side. The sweep to open it, and the dash is perfectly met. Counter hit as well on Veggie's side. Jester is not gonna challenge the bubblegum. But the anti-air works and the command grab, great choice. Veggie. On the leads this time. And a very slow paced, methodical match, of course, guys. Because the button's being whiffed, there is no risk taken. No risk taken from both sides. Oh my god, quick loss of sync on the CFN. Oh, bad choice. Dash, what? Okay. Great answer. Great answer by Veggie there. Jester Power is behind on life. Yeah, I think Street Fighter was tired of the slow pace, man. He did the timekeep itself. I was like, listen. These mans are not trying to play. We're gonna go faster. Alright, activation, but 7 seconds. And of course, Veggie knew that at this point, Jester had to take a risk. Or use the V-trigger. That was pretty much the obvious solution on this. Alright, the crouch fierce. He's blocked. Nice! We are on the grid, by the way, guys. This is a mod that I'm running to replace the grid into another stage. You can type exclamation mod if you want the detail for the mod, if you want to use the same. But the players are playing on the grid. We're just having a stage that is not the grid. Oh, charge it in full this time. Great escape. Okay. I just a looking gain to get the life lead back, but as soon as Veggie gets the life lead, he's chilling, he's letting Jester get frustrated, and then gets the one offensive moment. One touch, the shimmy is gonna work, Veggie is making it 4-1, three games ahead on the Norwegian side, looking to make it a convincing set. Jester Power struggling with Vega, I have to say. Abs is struggling, much love to generate TD. For joining us today, make yourself at home. We're having Wanted episode 5, and yes, it looks like we're gonna have a character change. Jester Power going back to the character select screen to potentially go for poison. Not entirely sure. Let's go to the back of the queue. Alright, Jester Power. Taking a moment to think. Alright, press the ready. Press the ready button. So let's see. I think we're gonna see poison from Jester. That's the choice. Then of course Veggie has a Colleen. If he wants to swap. Because knowing the range poison, the effective range poison has, might put some pressure on that birdie. Let's see, 4-1 anyway for Veggie. Remember that this is the qualifying set, so the winner of this set will be back next week to challenge the champion. Alright. We are getting poison indeed. V-Skill 2 for the mix-ups after NTRs. V-Trigger 1. Just the power gonna show us. Alright, and of course that's exactly gonna be the play on this. He's gonna play with the whip. And it's gonna be hard for birdie to challenge this. Depending on how dominant Jester Power gets with poison in this matchup, that might immediately make Veggie switch to Colleen. The backdash on the plus frames. Yeah, Street Fighter 5 has a lot of cool costumes, maybe. A lot of cool DLC costumes, crossovers from other games. But look at this, Veggie with a shimmy, my god! It only took 10 seconds for him to save the round. Alright, Jester. Ooh, getting countered! That's what Veggie's gonna look for, great answer though. By Jester Power, activation for him. Alright, dash in, yes, Dent, yeah, that's exactly why he wanted to use that V-Skill 2. The fire is down, the jump is perfect, great conversion, we're getting close to the stun, the anti-airing to the cartwheel, and he's gonna get the throw, able to build a tad bit extra meter, Jester Power is back. Okay, nice. Look at him charging. All right. Is this a reference? Maybe, yes. This is a lady from Devil May Cry. Now quite a few Devil May Cry characters, costumes I mean in the game. poison one of them, but the yes command grab goes in. For Vegan, he tried, but bad timing on this. Too bad, gets the jump. Properly anti-aired activation station. He's gonna use the plus frames. Bad conversion on this, Jesterboy could have gotten more. Couldn't he have cancelled this whip into the flames? Alright, Jester, get away. He's got his chain. Play with the whip. Keep that guy away. Keep that guy away, and what? An anti-air whip, full screen, your poison. Jester Power is getting his second game in this set. Definitely looking much better. Definitely looking much better with poison. It looks like he now swapped to a character that can allow him to get control in the set. The question is, how long will Veggie keep Birdie? I think it was pretty close, so he might try it again. But if that doesn't work, we might get a Colleen. But look at this, the standing medium. Oh my god, okay. When defense doesn't work, go full degen. But just a power with a mix. Yes. Nice conversion into the stun. Oh my god, he's playing with him right now. Oh, I tried to go for the cheeky reset. And the crush counter, you what a round. What a round for Jester Power. Poison is definitely saving the day for Jester. Alright, he's far away. Happy to stay in the corner, but as I say this, he tries to jump in. The overhead at least. It's not very meaty, but the back dash. To beat that command grab. And time for the throw. Good anti-air. Good V-Russell as well. Does not want to be put into these plus frames. Yo, that was a clean jump, man. Didn't use the cartwheel this time? Command grab. Oh, that's a bad jump, but could not get the full anti-air. He could not get the full anti-air on this. Trying the very long range jump-ins as well on Jester's side. Jester taking his time, but Veggie knows. Why would he take a risk right now? 35 seconds for him to wait. Down, back and chill. Oh my god! That was a golden chain, man. I just say you need to take a risk. 20 seconds remaining. You need to try and get in. It's not looking easy. You need a two-touch. Immediate two-touch, but that's not going to happen. Veggie saves the round. Okay, the jump. Oh, could not convert on this. Jester with a whip. Keep the man away. Keep him away. Oh my god, the trade. Might force him to reactivate. I wonder if poison could punish it as well anyway. With a whip. Oh, the chain hits anyway. And Veggie gets the conversion. Very good job by Veggie, by the way, in this matchup, man. Oh no! Oh no, he took the risk! And now it's a one-touch, and he took the risk. Yo, Jester, you are a madman. Took the risk again, and it paid off this time. Save the stun! Where's the command grab? Where? Oh my god, the walk forward command grab. That is what Jester got hit by at the end. And Veggie making it 5-2 in that first to seven. Two games remain for him. Come back next week and challenge the champion. So much love to man like Confs for the follow. Welcome, fam. Much love to that face guy and KV for joining us today as well. 5-2 in his first to seven, guys. Round one. Fight. All right, jump in. Nice. Oof. I don't hear. And that also sends him back to the corner, conveniently. I tried to whip through this, but not the right timing. Oh! Good escape. Good escape. Ah, he tried. That's unfortunate. On just a power side, Veggie gets yet another round. One round away from being in match point position. Veggie is looking so good in his set. Look, determined to come back next week on Wanted and challenge the champ. The chain. Once again, a huge life feed and the crush counter. That's not gonna close it yet, but it's the one touch. Oh my god, okay. Escape the situation. Oh no, another drop. Just a power unlucky on this. He still gets the long conversion. Another drop. These combos are not working on just the sides. And the anti-air for Veggie is gonna make it 6-2 on the Norwegian side. Unfortunate. Not sure if it's lag, but if it's just Jester being pure unlucky for today, but Veggie is one game away. One game away from qualifying to come back next week and face the champion and potentially get a position as a wanted champion. 6-2 now. Ouch. No, you don't care. Good jump in. Ooh, good answer to bubblegum, but that's not gonna lead Jester into a winning position anyway. Jester as well, by the way, kept with poison, which means he cannot switch back to claw. Cannot switch back to claw anymore. It's gonna be poison until the end of the set. The blocks. Oof! Jester trying to save his life. The cocktail Molotov is in, but the chain is gonna catch his toes. And that's gonna be two match points. Two match points for Veggie. The jump in was attempted, but Veggie's defense is looking way too good right now, guys. Stun? Dead chain, and Veggie is gonna be the winner of the qualifying set. 7-2 today. What a set! What a set it's been for him. The defense has been immaculate.